Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic molecular basis of inheritance, and now continue our topic with the enzymes involved in replication. Next enzymes comes the DNA polymerase, which is also called as Kornbug enzyme after the Kornbug's discovery. An extensive work with the DNA polymerase 1 of E. coli, a large number of DNA polymerase have been isolated. Now basically there are three forms of DNA polymerase 1, 2 and 3. They have been identified while studying E. coli and Bacillus subtilis. Now the precise function of some of the polymerase are still not clear. Early it was believed that polymerase 1 was considered as a major replicative enzyme. But while studying with some of the mutant of the polymerase enzyme, that means where the polymerase enzyme shows that the replication same as that of the normal range. Now polymerase 1 is mainly involved in the synthesis of DNA. It can add only the dinucleotide phosphate groups to the 3' end and form the polynucleotide. Now they are sliding DNA clamps. They are there to increase the degree of the processivity of the DNA polymerase. Sliding DNA clamps surrounding the DNA and binds the DNA polymerase and holding them together. Next enzymes comes the RNA's H. This completes the replication process and RNA primers are removed. RNA's H specifically degrade the RNA that are base paired with the DNA, and here RNA's HH stands for the hybrid, as RNA-DNA hybrid is seen in the strands. Now this enzyme is active only in the presence of magnesium ions and the pre-existing DNA. Last enzymes comes the DNA ligase. Nicks occur in the developing molecule. Nicks means breakage in the strand. Because the RNA primer is removed and the synthesis proceeds in the discontinuous manner, that means on the lagging strand. Here discontinuous synthesis is there, so that these nicks has to be joined. So for this, DNA ligase is the enzyme which mainly plays a role in the addition of these nicks in the lagging strand. So students, in this session we have seen more enzymes involved in the replication. In further session we will have more detailed look on the process of replication.